everybody, and welcome to TopSim. My name is William Lebowski, and we're doing something a little bit differently today, and that is the post-commentary race. And usually when you see myself in the bottom corner, I'm coming at you live through the middle of a race, except this race was far more challenging, and in fact, this was not my first time recording this, or my first day recording this, or my first session recording this, none of the above. It took a very long time for me to actually get this right and to get this going. And I shouldn't even say get this right, because to this day, and as you can tell by the title, this Bathurst Challenge is going to take more than one video to conquer. There's a lot to talk about in this video, but let's first jump into the car itself. This stock car, this Omega 1999 stock car, is a new release for AMS2. It's at the same time as that Group C release video. And before we really get into too much of this video, I decided after reading a comment that I need to be more positive about these sim racing videos, and it's something that I notice in other sim racing creators, is whenever I watch a video about someone making a video in sim racing that they don't like, it's like, oh man, there's so many flavors in all of sim racing, and you're choosing to make a video about the one that you specifically don't like. And so I don't want to be that person, so going forward I'm going to try to not be so harsh or so negative or so over the top negative or whatever it is. Just try to be more positive when it comes to these sorts of videos, because I think that makes the best content. At least that's what I look for when I want to watch videos. But aside from that, this car is amazing, and it really is overshadowed by the Group C car in the Group C update. That's as negative as I want to be going forward in this video about that. But this car is so fun to drive. It is so immersive, and it does something that no other car in AMS2 has managed to fully do, especially right out of the box, and that is be able to drive competitively at the limit as fast as possible in this car. This car is suited so much for what AMS2 is, between the AI driving, between the handling skills of the car, between the immersion. This car is just built for a 1999 stock car, the Omega 99 stock car. It's just perfect for this style of racing, for this loose rear end fishtail, crazy fast, nice close bumping, a little bit of contact, some intense racing. AMS2 is perfect for this style of racing. And one problem that I have with right out of the box AMS2 content is that sometimes the cars aren't drivable at that 100% limit. And this car does not have that problem. You could take this car immediately to 100% and try to pull out as many seconds or as many tenths as you can right out of the box. This car is an amazing driving experience. And I don't know what else to say, because I just feel like you can't be too positive when it comes to how this car performs. This car is so immersive and so high performing, I guess you could say, that I meant this video to be some sort of a live commentary. I was meant to be talking while recording this video. You can see myself in the bottom left-hand corner, and usually, if that happens, I'm there speaking at the same time as the recording is going down. But it was just too immersive. The experience required 100% of my attention, and not only did it require it, it just took it, even when I was planning to give it less than that. And so there's just a little bump in the gameplay in front of me. I bumped the car in front of me, and it created such a huge impact in the handling, and it just because of those moments like at that happened at 100%, that happened on the limit, or that happened in braking zones, it just requires that attention. And that is something that I feel like I can't pull out of cars in AMS2, so it's really nice to see this change of pace. Now, let's jump into the AI, because I feel like AI performance, when you have amazing AI performance, it really gets overlooked, because it's one of those things where the perfect version of something is when you don't notice it. Like the perfect mixing in a movie, so to say, you don't notice how perfect it is, because everything sounds so good together, everything sounds so balanced and compressed together. And so the AI is kind of turning to that in AMS2, which is an amazing step forward from what we had from release in AMS2, that The AI are now at the point where they're so good you don't notice their problems, you don't notice their shortcomings, and so you don't necessarily think to praise them. But when I think about where the AI in AMS2 has come from, my very first time recording and making a video and having to spend days at Interlagos just because the AI kept punting me in the middle of corners, to go from that experience to all of a sudden having this amazing, tight, close contact, door-to-door racing here at Bathurst in these stock cars. So it's an amazing update. It's an amazing proof of progress, proof of concept for AMS2. I am interested in to see where the hot fixes go. I did read a comment in my last video about those Mercedes Sauber C9 and those Group C cars with the way the turbo works, the way that I was experiencing, some jostling was explained to me about the way the turbos work. But I am hoping to see Group C get a little bit of an adjustment through time as it goes on. But this stock car group is where I'm going to be spending a lot of attention, specifically at Bathurst. I'm creating some sort of a Bathurst challenge for myself. And for a very long time, it was impossible for me just to get through a practice lap at Bathurst. And then, eventually sessions later, you get through, a practice lap and you get the course down, and now you're running laps there. Not fast laps, very slow, but you can get through the course. And then you start trying to sneak out a little bit more time from your time. And eventually you're getting to the point where you can drive, 100% on all parts of the mountain in Bathurst. And that's kind of where I got to. And now I'm kind of at the point now where I really need to get the consistency of putting all of those pieces together. Because, we're three laps into it, this race. We're about to finish, go on to our fourth lap here at Bathurst, and I am so far making it through the race. But spoiler alert, there's going to be an accident coming through at some point in time. I won't tell you when, but it's one of those mistakes. Both, you could blame it on whatever the situation is, but if you find yourself in a bad position, if you put your car in an if you make an unsafe move, put your car in a terrible position, bad things are likely to happen. So even if you do something kind of iffy, and something kind of iffy happens to you, it's kind of it makes sense because you kind of put yourself in that situation in the race car. So we're going on to the fourth lap here, and I just need to put all these pieces together, and I think I'm going to have a harder time actually taming Bathurst than imagined. And what do I mean by taming Bathurst? I want to be able to race Bathurst in many sections of or many classes and groups of cars, and I think this 99 stock car is the perfect entry level. I was trying on GT3 cars for so long, but there's just something about the power and weight and the craziness in the racing and the immersion that AMS2 provides. So I think that this is going to be a huge challenge for me, a huge battle to me to get moving forward through Bathurst and eventually get that five lap race done, eventually get some longer periods of time, maybe some endurance style racing, AI endurance level racing, maybe an hour races or something like that, or live stream sessions or at Bathurst or something like that in these stock cars, and then moving forward into the more difficult cars, and Lord forbid something like prototypes or something crazy like an open wheeler up the mountain. But that is kind of where we're at. I am realizing how much more of a bite that Bathurst is than just a place to race, like it is any other track. And so here I see myself getting loose, getting too fast and loose with it, bouncing into the wall, damaging my car. So I'm thinking, maybe at this point, I'm fine. But making even more contact with other cars, and then boom, the car is just damaged and destroyed. You can see how disappointing it was to me. But that's the video. Thank you guys for watching. I do appreciate it. Subscribe for more of these Bathurst videos where we try to conquer it, as well as some more escapades into sim racing. I don't know if that was the correct word usage, but anyway, thank you guys for watching. We'll see you in the next one, and the music is by Night Mode. No, it's by Stream Beats.